I was in Washington, D.C., and I was waiting in line for a movie. This was back when you couldn't buy stuff online. It was in the 80s. So you had to wait in line for 30 or 40 minutes before the movie started.
And you waited online because the price was too low and there weren't enough seats. So only the people who were lined up with it open could get in. It's not just to get the good seats.
I think the price was too low because I'm rich. The poor people thought the price was just right.
Right. Okay.
Because they had more of the resource that this was testing for. So that spoken
point.
Like a typical wealthy person, that everything should be the one resource you have a lot of.
No, it's the neoclassical economist who sometimes forgets that positive and normative are not the same thing. I apologize. Carry on.
In line. I'm standing in line. And if you're standing in line for a long time, you know the people around you. I'm talking to the guy behind me, and I turn around, and there is a small, 5'2", slender woman who was not there before. And I say, "You can't cut in line like that." And she immediately looked up at me and said, "If you say another word, I'm going to call the police and say you assaulted me." Now, I was completely undone. I remember it so vividly, and I also remember, I don't remember anything about the movie. I was so upset. I could not sleep that night. I was so upset at this transgression of the rules. Now, what did she cost me? What would the economist say she cost me? 20 seconds?
Kind of. I mean, you didn't even have to pay attention to her, but you did. Your brain took it in. Is that what you mean? You're saying what did she cost you to hear her?
Well,
for cutting in line.
Objectively, what did cutting in line? It meant
is she
that
in front
of
you or behind you?
In front.
Oh, I like behind because it's even better.
I don't think it would have made a difference. I think I would have been just as upset.
Yeah, of course. But cutting in front of you made no difference as long as she didn't prevent you from seeing the movie. And she
probably 20 seconds extra where she paid for her ticket and went inside.
Yeah.
I was so upset that I didn't sleep that night. And I still remember the incident. So the point is, we are evolved to provide the public good of norm enforcement against our will. It's irrational. I should not, if you were an economist, I should not have provided this public good of norm enforcement. However, if I live in a society where all of us do provide the public good of norm enforcement, there is an emotion called shame, which is, I know that I did it. And there's an emotion, forgive me, called guilt, meaning that I know that I did it. And there's one called shame where I'm upset when other people point to me and said, he did it. Those two things mean that much of the problem of policing bad action is taken away. The society actually solves the problem itself. So there is a group rationality argument, and this is something that Hayek talks about quite a bit. There's a group rationality argument for having an adapted moral sense. So morality is not a disadvantage, except that an individual sociopath like that woman might be able to invade this society as a mutant, because there's not 150 of us anymore. There's 1 million people that live in Washington, D.C. I'll never see her again. She paid no cost. So long as she has no sense of guilt, she paid no cost for cutting in line.